Good evening.
Good evening.
Okay. I got the accessible version of good evening. So. Good. I thought everyone will nod like this. You know, which often people do. When I say good morning or good evening, they say yeah. And I don't often understand, you know, why people do that. Because they see the cane in my hand and they say like this, or they wink their eyes. And I often do. I also wink my eyes, you know. And my name is Raghava. What I do is I'm a digital accessibility consultant. I know you understood digital and consultant, not accessibility. I'll empower you with that one. I'll enable you guys a little bit about something. We'll learn something together. And what do I do? Where I come from? I'm not someone who is born blind. I became blind. About 3 years back, I lost complete both my eyes. And it was a progressive. Like 14 years back, I stood in front of an ophthalmologist and they said, the boy is 80% blind and we can't do anything. And I've been going through that phase of losing eyesight day in, day out. Like I can see something today and I cannot see that something tomorrow. So every day I have to learn and unlearn everything when my eyesight diminishes, day by day. And at the age of 18 and 19, I went for a campus placement. They said, I'll be blind soon, so I need a job. And they said, we don't know how blind people work. I said, I know how blind people work. And they said, you know, we'll get back to you. And this has been going on. And some people even asked, you know, would you like to work for 6 months without salary so that we understand your strengths? And I was not comfortable because my friends are doing well and I'm not. Then I went to a friend's house. He's doing web design. I said, what do you do? I said, with websites you can make money. I came home. I started Google. I learned everything about web design. And I whip out my first website. And I said, how do you make money now? He said, Google AdSense. 2006, I started. 3 years. I was very independent. I ran my own digital marketing agency. I used to do HTML and all that. And I built considerable amount of web templates and you know, I was doing SEO, social media and all that. And I'm self-sufficient since the age of 19. I made good amount of money. I was never able to scale it up because of my visual impairment, because I had to fight day in, day out with my visual impairment. And because of my visual impairment, from a very young age, I have learning disability. Now, I can't learn everything as when it comes to technology and coding, like how others do. You know, you can sit in a class or you can go through a book and understand. It takes long hours for me to go through a code, understand it, or write that code. And it was pain at the start. And I thought, okay. And it came to a point where I can't see anything on the computer screen. Then I went to Bangalore and learned computers where they teach screen readers. Now, what is a screen reader? It's a text-to-speech engine. So what happens is, anything that is there in the text format on your screen, your computer talks back to you. It was a very interesting technology. I learned it. I said I can't do any freelancing or entrepreneurship. I'll want a job, you know. You need an iPhone. You need an iPhone. At least I need an iPhone. So I said, okay. Then I joined MNC. I worked there in the accessibility space. Then I moved to another company 2 years back. I still do accessibility. And how many of you got iPhone here or Android? I know you all lifted your hand like this, and I have to look into the space because the antenna has sent the signal and I can't hear it. This is what is called accessibility, guys. What is accessibility is you are here today because this information about WordCamp is accessible to you in some or the other format. It has reached you guys. If it doesn't reach you, that means it was not accessible to you guys. Now, if I build a wall in that entrance and doesn't allow you inside, is this hall accessible to you? If this hall do not have a ramp, is this accessible for someone who is using a wheelchair? And how do you think the content that you produce, the development that you do, the design that you think and create on the web is accessible for someone who is disabled? How do you reuse it? Now, I am someone with learning and, you know, visual disability. How a person with motor disability use it? How a person with cerebral palsy use it? How a person with colorblind use your designs? Do, you know, everyone agrees that we are, you know, a good tech capital. India is like a good tech space.
Yes.
Oh, you are all proud of it?
Yes.
At the same time, I'm not proud of it. Being the tech capital of everything, we doesn't know tech standards. Yeah, we know how to write a HTML code, we know how to write a CSS code, but do we know how to write it with the standard in mind? No. How many of you use Flipkart here? Everyone? Snapdeal?
Yes.
Ola?
Yes.
Oh, I'm a big user of all. The only difference is, if I need to book Ola, I have to call up Alex and say, Alex, I'm in Bandra, so please put your location to Bandra and book me and SMS me the driver number, because they are not accessible. I have to use Flipkart. Now, I have a huge library. I have about 500 physical copy of books. I have about 1,000 of digital audiobooks in my house. I read like anything. And you know what? There's no e-commerce store in India who can sell to me today. Because I can't read the product description first. The product image do not have an alt text. Now how will I know what's the difference? You know, he says black phone. I don't know what is black and what is silver. He says measurements, you know. And it's a CSS image, background image. No descriptions. Now, how will someone with like me understand all that? Okay? So, this is what accessibility is. This is what I do day in, day out. I make digital products accessible for enterprises. I work as a full-time employee with a company called Deque. We do only accessibility. We don't do anything else. So, and I do testing, I do a little bit of development, manage, a little bit of coding, not much. Okay, so this basically that is my story. And coming to WordPress, now I stumbled on WordPress in 2006 when I'm doing link building. I started using WordPress.org hosted version from 2008. And WordPress basically is a very accessible platform. Okay, now, it has been an accessible platform for a long time. It has got few bugs, but there's a WordPress accessibility team of volunteers who are doing a tremendous job, a great job. And most of the core of WordPress is accessible. Now, you build a website on WordPress. You install a theme. Is the theme accessible? Now, when I say accessibility, you need to think from just not from the visual impairment point of view. Is it colorblind enabled? Are your colors, color palettes the right way? The foreground and the background is correct or not? Is every element on your page's keyboard open? And you're able to tab into it? Now it so happened that last week I was on a event ticketing website and I entered everything, you know, first name, last name, number of tickets I want, everything. And I tabbed. There's no button to say, you know, check out. And I was looking desperately. And, you know, I have to call someone and say, hey, I'm on this flight, I'm doing this one. Can you just check, you know, if something is wrong from my end? And they say, the checkout button is in a small iframe that is not accessible with a keyboard. It's a mouse over event. Did they lose that say? Yes, they lost that. Like I'm working with an accessible tourism company that started in India called Planetable. And she sends me an event platform asking, you know, Raghava, we need an accessible platform that can, you know, people with disabilities can buy tickets. I said, there's none. None in India. But we can build one with WooCommerce event plugin and WordPress. And I'm very sure about it because I played with WordPress day in, day out since last six, 7 years. And I learned how to edit themes. I know how to edit a bit of plugins. I can take an external jQuery and write, embedded it in the WordPress theme that I'm working on. And we are working towards that. So these are the things that you need to see. You need to see if you can tab into it. Now, how do you know you might ask me, how will I know my colors are accessible? There's a tool called Color Contrast Analyzer. I'll give you all the set of tools. I'll tweet everything. There's something called Color Contrast Analyzer. You put your foreground, you put your background, and it will tell you if it passes that ratio 4.5:1. And who sets all these things, you might ask me. You know, there's something called World Wide Web Consortium. They do something called, they have WCAG, which is Web Content Accessibility Guidelines. It's a version 2.0 right now. And there's like 61 checkpoints that you need to pass to see a website is compliant with that. Like in India, no one follows them. In US, it's a federal law that all the federal government websites should be accessible. And recently, United States has come up with a saying that any airline that is operating in United States must be accessible. That means I should be able to get my ticket, I should be able to check my itinerary and do all that. Now, how many of you think that is digital equality? Don't you think this is a very important thing?
Yes.
Don't you think, is it not a discrimination that we create something that is not usable by everyone? Now, I'll tell you how this changed my life. I'll tell you how WordPress has changed my life. Now, I started blogging in 2009 when I'm living all alone in Bangalore. Okay, I have nothing else to do. I don't have friends. I was working with this MNC. And I started writing my blog. And I started getting some traffic from Twitter, Facebook, and Google. And I met all these people. Like the first 100 people that I met virtually on my blog are the first 100 people I met in Bangalore physically. And that was a very powerful thing. And one more powerful thing is, when I'm writing, so what I was writing is my own life story there. So today this happened. Today I fell down in a manhole. Today a car guy came and hit me. Today I went into a fight with the auto guy. And these are the things that did. I used to write all these things, and what happened is one day I got a call, and he said, Raghava, I read your blog, I've stumbled it on through Google, I'm going blind, and I wanted to die, because I'm all alone in my life, and I don't know what to do with it. I have a job, but I feel very lonely. When I read your blog, you said, start writing. I decided I'll also start a blog. And you know what? He said he wanted to live. Because he said he has a story to live, to tell to the world. And he want to see, he said, and that would have been not possible if I'm not writing on WordPress. WordPress. And I tried every CMS there, every CMS out there. Joomla, I tried it. You name it, I have tried it. Can anything make it simple? WordPress make it very, very simple for me. I don't have to learn anything new. It's all there, you know. Posts, add new. Pages, add new. Plugins, install. And I can tell you dashboards, you know, every table where every heading is on WordPress on the fly from my memory right now. So that's a kind of intuitive experience a design can give you, an accessible platform can give you. And as a customer, I am ready to pay any amount. I can go to any. Like last week, I was in Delhi doing another talk in a tech conference on HTML5. And I have a friend who is wheelchair. And she said, Raghava, where are you staying? I said, I don't know still. She said, there's this hotel that is very accessible, and they take care of people with disability well. And I opened it, and they said $200 a night. And I did not even think twice to pay $200 a night. For 4 days, because I thought If it is accessible, they are worth paying for it. And every minute of my experience was great over there. And I went to Taj Mahal. The guide comes in and says, I'll give you an accessible tour of Taj Mahal. $1,000. I said, fine. And someone else comes and, you know, I come back from Taj Mahal and someone says, it's only 200. I said, I paid 800 top up for that accessible experience. Because no one else does it. As Nira was saying, you know, you should sell what your customers want. I need this. Can you sell me? I'm ready to buy. And you will say, a lot of people argue with me statistics. Do you guys know what is a disability market share? 80 million people in India are disabled. Multiplied with, you know, 7 billion people. And you know, we are the most, we spend more time digital than anyone else. Because you don't see us in the shopping malls, you don't see us in cinema theaters and all. That doesn't mean we don't exist, we exist. We spend more time digital than any other common person. You name it, we know the technology, you name it, we did it. Like I've been in jungles, I did cave explorations, I did bungee jumps. Like I'm doing my skydive next week. I travel around the world. I traveled like five countries now. And I'm a blind solo traveler. I traveled across India. I'm doing a trip next year that I want to capture as a story book on WordPress, using WordPress again. Storybook using WordPress across India. I want to travel solo and see what it is like to connect with bloggers that who never met me, you know? And all this because of WordPress, because I started writing. And how do you make your WordPress accessible? Your themes and your plugins. Everyone developers here? You all need to think of accessibility from day now. You make a carousel, you need to think of accessibility. You make a form, contact form. Most of the contact forms are not accessible. You use placeholders. No, I need a label there. You know what happens when you use placeholder? People with short-term memory doesn't know what's happening on the form. I input one word and the placeholder is gone. And I don't know how to, after I come back after a while, I don't know what's happening. Forms, people doesn't use labels. How many of everyone use responsive design?
Yes.
Yes, I know. You know, but one wrong thing you do is your labels are beside your forms. They should be on the top because low vision people use their phone very near to the eye. And all of us are going to grow old in 20 years. So what are you guys going to do using your own tools? You will be disabled to use your own tools. This is what is going to happen. Most of the younger generation now is going to grow old and they'll have something called elderly disabilities. Are you ready to capture that market? Are we ready now? No. We should create. There's a huge market, guys. There's an accessible dating app that came out of Mumbai now. People are getting married and getting on that one. There's accessible tourism. Now, I'm very interested in tourism. You know, I was waiting for someone to start something of that sort. Tomorrow someone says, you know, I have accessible this, I would have gone. You'll see me there. I went on accessible treks. And what is the automation tools you can use? How many of you got iPhones and Androids? Oh, remove them outside. We'll do a small exercise. Okay, open your iPhone, go to settings,
bring your iPhone,
iPhone or Android, anything. Ready? Go to settings, there's something called accessibility inside it. There's something called voiceover, switch it on. In Android it is talk back, guys. It starts talking. Now close your eyes and just imagine doing it. And start swiping. So much difference. You hear those voices, the digital voice? Just imagine if I have to hear it every day, 12 to 15 hours. Yeah, whoever is not able to switch it off, na, come to me after the talk. We'll do one-on-one invitation, invite only.
$100 for switch off.
Yeah. Okay. So this is how we work. Just imagine closing your eyes. And, okay, quiet them now. It's done. So when you normally touch, is it single touch? When you touch something on an accessible version, it is double touch. So double tap on switch off, not single touch. Everything is double tap. Everyone is switched. So this is how you do manual testing. Open your website in this or application, and you'll know what are the bugs that you are getting.
We are setting up a new desk outside where we'll charge you $20 to switch this off.
Can come to me, it's free. Okay, and automation testing, there are plugins called HTML5 Code Sniffer, Axe Accessibility Rules Engine, and we have Todo A11y from, I think, Khan Academy again. So these three you can use. Axe has got a very good Firefox plugin. You can just use that Firefox plugin to test all your theme pages and all that. It doesn't give you false positives. So when you go on any accessibility, for colors, you can use this another tool called colorsafe.co, colorsafe.co. If you give you the background color, it will give you the foreground color that is accessible to that particular background color. It's a very helpful tool during your designs, visual design. Yeah. I'll share the slides. They are there in the resources slider over here. Any questions, guys? Yeah, we'll switch it off. I'll help you guys out. Whoever is not able to switch it off, yeah. So,
any other questions?
No questions?
I have a question, Raghava.
Yeah.
If I have to get started with accessibility, where do I start? What should be my gateway kind of a thing into accessibility? What should I like focus on first before anything else?
Because you get your designs first, I would say is get your visual design correct and get the color contrast. Because most of them get the color contrast wrong, and then they get the forms wrong.
The forms.
If it's a static site, if you have custom widgets, there's something called ARIA, A-R-I-A. It's called Accessible Rich Internet Application. You can use it with your jQuery JavaScript. So ARIA is a new attributes on your HTML to make any kind of complex widget accessible. Any other questions?
Hello, everybody. Yeah. So not a question really, but just wanted to share something on accessibility. We made an app for a client in London. It was called Spy. And the client made the app for, you know, kind of a for fun purpose where you switch on the app and you can really amplify the voice for, you know, so he wanted to do it for spying purpose. But, you know, just kind of doubling on your this accessibility market. Every day, I think maybe 500,000 people are downloading those app, and maybe around 20-30% are people who have this kind of ear problem. You know, so they are utilizing this for amplifying the voice around them.
Yes.
So yeah, you know, Like,
we normally don't know there's something called disabilities that cannot be seen. So hearing impairment is one of it. You know, people with mental mind-related disabilities is one. And something called hard of hearing. That means they can hear, but you need to be little amplify the voice, and it's called hard of hearing. So I think those people will be using that app
a
lot.
Yes. Great.
So that shows there's a market. Any other questions? If not, thank you guys. It's nice being here. Yes.